All right, so I'm gonna go over my rod case and show you why I prefer this exact rod case over anything else that's out there. To start off with, this is a pretty big rod case. So as you can see, it sits up pretty high, it's pretty thick, and it's hard plastic, and it's made by Plano. This is actually a gun case. This is the type of case if you're gonna have a big expensive rifle and you're gonna be traveling long distances to hunt or maybe even overseas, this is the kind of case you're gonna buy for that gun. And so why not do that for your rod, your ice rods? You might have several hundred dollars worth of ice fishing gear and just your reels and your rods, and that can only mean maybe three or four rods. So the last thing you would want to do is to carry them in a soft case or a light plastic case that could crush under weight and something that may not even be waterproof. So we're going to get right into this case and see how it looks. This case here is not a very light case, but how I carry it around is I pull it in my sled. So it has all these buckles here. Let's check this out. All right. So there's my rods. All right, so let's get right into the rods here first. So we can answer a lot of these questions of what this is, and we'll get right back to the case. All three of these rods are tickle sticks. This is their smallest tickle stick, the Ultralight 23, with a Black Betty reel on. These are made by 13 Fishing. This has a Quantum reel on it, and this one here is the 27-inch Ultralight. And this is an even bigger rod, and this is the 38-inch light. And I have an HT reel on there. A pretty good reel for HT. Now I have this is what I carry around if I'm gonna be using, say I wanna set this up, I can use that as my rod holder, have one out on the ice in a hole. Here's some of my cases and just some extra line and a slender spoon and stuff. Now notice this is a pluck out case. So you can see all these little squares, and you would pluck those out and you can save them. Like you can see, I took this one out and I put it right back in. So you can, you don't, when you pluck these out for your reels, you want to make sure that you don't throw these away, because you could, if you ever want to change something, you can always put these right back in. Now, I do not like tearing the reels apart, because if I want to change stuff quick, I want a reel and it's blowing cold wind outside, okay, I don't want to be fumbling around trying to screw on and get my reels all set up. So I can actually pull this right up, boom, ready to go fish right now. The only thing is yes, you do have to have your reel in the right place, your handle, for this to go right back in. Now, I even carry, this is the bug luggage and this little Plano tackle box. Spoons, I got slender spoons, tumbler spoons, jiggin wraps, perch talkers, Northland Forge spoons, buckshot spoons. This is what I go for the bigger stuff. This is where I keep all of my tungstens, right there. And as you can see, they're all nice and organized here. These are all Fiscus tungstens, and I should have enough to last me forever. I know some guys kind of, they make a collection out of these, but this I just got enough that would last me probably a good 3 or 4 years, because you know, you do have some break off and some will chip the paint, and I mean, there's the colors that I like to use often. Some of those are glow, and then I have a couple of these, you know, black and off-colored metallic, just in case nothing else is biting. But these are my ones that seem to be working the best, more than any other colors, are those ones right there. All different sizes. As you can see on this rod case, it also has the foam. Most rod cases just have a piece of foam here. Skip this pluck out stuff. And then this on the bottom, your reels are bouncing around here. Then this is very flimsy up here, so you could push down way down in, and you can get stuff crushed very easily. What I like about this is you can see on here, there's this ridge that goes the whole way around here. There's a rubber gasket, or almost like an O-ring, right here. There's like an O-ring in here, and that pushes right down on there and makes a waterproof seal. That really makes it nice. So like when you're out, you know, and like right now I'm not in a shanty, but if it was just howling wind and just super, super cold, and you know, you're gonna have your case covered in snow, and then let's say it warms up, it could be raining, whatever, I could set this out and I don't have to worry about anything. Now, like I said, I carry this usually in a big sled when I'm carrying around my stuff, and I just like it. I can carry a lot of stuff in here, and this closes right up. So I'm not gonna give a weight, but I mean, if you had to carry this around all day just with the rod, it would probably get a little heavy. That's why, like I said, I carry it around in a sled, but I'm on an old farm pond right now, so I didn't have to go anywhere. I'm not carrying my sled, but you know, I can just, I don't care, you know, it's just, I don't have to worry about it. I could throw it in the bed of my truck. I can get it covered in dirt. I can just beat this thing up and stand. I don't have to worry about my rod and reel. When I have this stuff in here, it's gonna be right in place, tucked in, so I don't have to worry about anything else going wrong. And you can see it hasn't even, there's still lots of room. So even if you do push on this a little bit, there's so much foam, you could push way down on this and I never have to worry about it. I know a lot of guys, they have, there are some ice rod manufacturers out there that make really good heavy duty cases. Sometimes they're even made out of metal, which means you can get them smaller than this and they weigh just as much as this big one. That's why I like the all plastic. Plus then you don't have to worry about corrosion or anything else. Even if, you know, I throw this in the bed of my truck, I'm going down the highway and there's salt going all over the place, it gets on here, I just pressure washer it off. You know, with a metal one, you know, over time you're probably going to get a little bit of corrosion, and it's just lighter. That's why I like it. And another thing is, see, I could put a 38 inch rod in here and I still have a little bit more room, and that's what I like about it. I can just pick these up out when I need to. Like I said, I have that just in case, made by Northland. So if I have a rod that I want to set over a hole and I want to switch quick, I don't have to worry about having this case open the whole time. If it's really windy and I get snow in here, I can just close it right back up and have a rod sitting out ready to go. So there's my rod case. I really like it. It may not be for you, but for what I like to do, if you're going to have really expensive rods and you want to take care of them and you're rough on stuff at the same time, you know, I like buying really nice stuff, but at the same time, I'm extremely rough on stuff, and that's what I just want. I want something I don't have to worry about being meticulous on where I'm putting them in the vehicles. You know, I hear lots of guys breaking tickle stick tips off because, well, you know, they bumped them into something, or they threw them in the bed of their truck, and you know, or it got pinched or slammed into something, broke the tips off. This here, I know they're not going to move. I could throw this thing. If it falls out of the bed, I have somebody else carrying them. I don't have to worry about if somebody puts something heavy on top of here, it's going to not crush them. Now, don't test it out and try to drive over it with a semi-truck, because, it probably will crush it, but you know what I'm talking about. So there it is. It's a Gun Guard by Plano. They make multiple different sizes of these. But this one here, I believe, is, 42 or 43 inches long. So, yep, good thick stuff. And like I said, if you didn't want to carry your other stuff, you could probably pick and pluck different stuff, but I just carry three rods with me, and that's good enough for me. Okay, so there I got I use a Nils 6-inch hand auger. And in case somebody asked me about these gloves, these are Striker gloves. And what I like about these is, let me put one of them on. These are mitt crossovers. So you can pop the back out and they can be a mitt. Then you can pull these back, they'll button in place, and you can use your free hand. Perfect, lots of room down inside here. Right in here, you can see a big gap that you could put like a hand warmer in. And what's also awesome is your thumb can come off and stick out. Plus, you could pull your thumb and your finger out to tie your line or something when it's really cold, and then you can just flip them right back in. You can even lock down your thumb so it's not getting in the way. Pretty nice gloves. The only problem is if your hands get really, really wet and you try to put these gloves back on, they are going to be a little bit more difficult to put on because of the smaller diameter of this inner glove. And it sort of kind of is a little bit difficult to put on, but just going to use the mitt to pick up your fish, then, you know, this is kind of a hard nylon on the outside here, so it's not like cloth where it's going to just get all sticky and gooey. All right, so for my flasher, I'm using a Markham LX9, and you can see right there, we got all kinds of fish right underneath me, lots of fish. This is actually the one with the video camera on the back, and I only bought that only because I make YouTube videos. If I wasn't gonna make the YouTube videos, I probably wouldn't get that. It's just it's kind of a luxury thing with the camera. There's cheaper cameras out there, but I just got that just so that I could record and make videos with it. And so I really like this. You know, it works really great. So what I'm using is the Striker hard water suit. This is the top and the bibs also. And I tell you what, I love this because not only does it help you float if you do happen to break through the ice, but I just like the stiffness of the hood. It stays up, it's not falling or flapping over. And I'm telling you, this thing is extremely warm, and it keeps the it really does keep the wind off. And so I don't even think you'd even need a shelter. I mean, you could fish outside of brutal weather in this thing. I think you'd have more of a difficult time trying to keep your line from freezing up than and your holes from being frozen than you getting cold. But now what I use for my boots is I just use muck boots, insulated muck boots. And they seem to be pretty good. Thing is I don't care what you're using. If you're going to be on the ice, sooner or later your feet will get cold. That's why you want to try to bring some type of little piece of wood, there's some mats, exercise mats. A lot of guys bring those just to keep your feet off the ice. That'll help you keep your feet a lot warmer on these brutal cold days when you're sitting on the ice. All right, so I'm on this old farm pond, and let's catch a fish here real quick. Now, here's what I would do on any hole. I like these because they have pads, and I can actually put my knees right down on the ice. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to open this up. Okay, so I'm going to get into my case. Grab the medium rod here real fast. I'm going to take this smaller one, and I'm just going to set it. Just going to set it right here, so I can try it out a little bit later. But I got. I'm going to try to use some plastics today. Not even sure the name of these plastics, but a little pink tungsten jig, probably in the 3.5, 4.5 millimeter size, and. Let's drop down here and see if we can find some fish here. Here we go. Got wrapped up the transducer. Got a whole big school of bluegills down there. Now, like I said, I'm on an old farm pond just out to catch and to show you guys what's going on. So let's go look and watch the screen to show you what I'm actually seeing. Is this red line here is our bottom. You can see the 10, saying 9.5, but our true bottom is probably around 10 feet because this is a really soft bottom. There's a little bit of weeds and some dirt on the bottom. Now, here's our zoomed in on the side, and you can see this is bottom, and all these marks right here are fish. When they go red, that means they're directly under the fish finder. If they're blue, that means they're out here on the side of the transducer or the cone angle underneath the ice. So now, when I drop down, and we're going to take this little jig, and you're going to see it come from up on top. And there's our jig right there. You can see I'm moving it up and down, up and down. And we're going to drop. Now look, we're seeing some of these fish are coming right underneath. They're getting red. And they're looking at it. They're coming close. And we're going to drop it right down there. We're just going to kind of dangle this thing back and forth. See, now one's coming up. They're on it, but they're not biting. They're right on it. So once those marks come up and touch my mark, I quit looking at the screen and I start watching the tips of my... tickle stick. And I start watching for that little bit of movement on the end of that rod. There we go. There is our fish that we just caught. So let's go look at that one more time and then we'll go to the tickle stick tip and watch how that works. Dropping down, dropping down. Now look, fish instantly comes in, comes over. As soon as one of those marks come and touch my mark, I stop looking at the flasher and I start looking at my rod. So I'm just going to kind of make him want to come after, get him separated, maybe some other fish. Okay, now I'm going to stop watching and I'm going to start watching my rod. And if I don't see anything, they're probably just right there on it. I'm going to just kind of separate it again and see if they want to come up on it. If not, I'll drop back down because we've got fish on the bottom. And you want to get into a lot of fish because the more fish, the more they'll kind of fight over it and they'll kind of get a little bit more aggressive that way. See, I can't even see my jig because there it is. It's separating. Lots of fish are on it right now. There we go. And we got another one. And there it is there. So let's go check out the tip of this tickle stick. Now I switched this over to the small one because it has a lot more of a sensitive tip. And we're just gonna drop this down. Okay, we got fish on it. Now let's just watch and see. There, did you see that? Watch. See that little nibble? See the little nibbles? Bring it back down. There we go. See how sensitive that tip is. And there we go. See all the bigger that is. I mean, it's the size smaller than the size of my pinky nail, with just a little tiny plastic on it. Now I'm gonna try to jiggle it a little bit. There we go. We're on again. You can see how this works. The backbone of the rod here is staying straight, and it's just the tip that's being bent. This is a very little bluegill. So now one thing with crappie. Lots of times you can see how this has a slight curvature to it, just ever so slightly. Okay, you want this just to be enough that you just have a little bit of weight on your line just to pull this over, so that when those fish do hit it, it brings it down. Now a crappie sometimes will hit on the upstrike, and let's say you're fishing and this is the way your rod is, and a crappie will hit up and actually leave tension off of your line like that. If that happens, you'll know that you have a crappie on, or even any type of fish that might hit on the upbite. So that's what I like about this rod, is you can see the upbites and the downbites on both of these. So let's go drop this back down. And I really, really, really like this reel. I'm telling you, it took a little bit to get used to, but I caught the biggest bass, okay? I'm using this reel. You gotta have your drag set right. It is the 27 or the 23 ultralight. Okay, It's very, very short rod with only 3 pound test trilene ice monofilament. And with even the smallest tungsten jig that you can buy, I caught the biggest largemouth bass. I'm going to show you a picture of it right now. This was on Kale Lake in western Pennsylvania. And I fought this thing for like a good, I don't know, 5 or 6 minutes. I had no idea what I had. I thought I foul hooked some kind of a perch, a big perch or something. But I mean, I was surprised it didn't fight that hard. But with the drag, helped me catch this bass. I mean, it's the biggest bass I ever caught, open water or hard water. Just an amazing, amazing fish to ever catch on light tackle with a rod. But you can see here in the hole that it filled up the whole 6-inch hole. Okay, let's go back and see if we can watch this strike on here again. Sometimes they're just playing with that little bit. They're being so finicky that even when they try to suck it in, there we go. You can see that it wasn't bent down a whole lot. It was just a little bit of movement. Oh, it come off, but I had one on. Now there, I don't know if you got to see that one, but that was such a light bite. There we go again. Okay, now maybe you'll be able to see the screen and my rod at the same time. Now if you look closely, there's my jig on the screen. It's going down. Got fish getting ready to come up to it already. There we go, that didn't take long. This isn't about catching the monsters here for this video. This is just demonstrating how this is done. So you guys that don't have a flasher and want to watch something that you don't normally see in the YouTube videos, guys showing exactly how they're doing it and getting to see that screen. Coming back up, I got bites already. Oh, missed it. See if you guys can watch the screen. Watch the screen up here. See, I got fish following it the whole way up the hole. Watch the screen up here. And when you see that fish coming up to my jig, then watch my pole. And that's how you have to use the flasher. If you're just watching the flasher, never look at your pole, then a tickle stick really doesn't have anything. You're going to be going on feel, and I don't like going on feel. You can catch more fish by going on sight, because there's times where fish, you're never going to feel them bite. So there's the jig. It's coming down. It's a little bit hard to see when it's blue. There it's coming down now. We got a lot of green coming up. They're coming up to it. Okay, bringing it back down. Oh, wow, that was fast. Probably didn't even have time to watch anything on the screen. There you can see the jig going down. We got lots of fish down there. Okay, I'm gonna stop it. Got one coming up instantly right there. That's a little bit of a bigger fish. A little bit bigger of a bluegill. So there you go. That's how you catch all those fish, by using a flasher.